Jay White, Dylan Satilli here at the Pioneer Classic. First batter, first pitch right here. In for a strike.
Good job working ahead by Pogue. So we're playing Newkirk.
Newkirk Tigers.
Yeah, I'm going through their game changer. And they've won against some pretty good teams. Perkins beat them 4-3. Morrison, their 3A powerhouse, beat them 5-2.
Oh, good pitch. A little different strike zone here. Two balls, one strike. Good job calling it off. Good job there, girls. Aubrey makes a play there, a little pop-up.
That was a good job. She just took control, so that's mine, and she went and got it.
Yep. Vap was the batter. Called strike. First pitch to Carlton.
Yeah, Newkirk, they've also beaten Fort Gibson. Yeah, they're a good 4A team. So
they're going to be solid.
Yeah, 20-8 record.
1-1. To Carlton from Aubrey. Got her swinging. One ball, two strikes.
A nice rise ball up in zone.
Oof. Oh.
Got her.
Got her. Got her looking. I like the way we're starting out this game a lot better.
That pitch looked, it looked, I mean, it could have been a ball. I mean, it was right there.
Yeah, it's close.
It was close.
It was tailing in. Good job, Aubrey.
Oh, she's a machine.
Today. What? Aubrey, you a lot of times let's say roll. Not today. Well, we saw why. She about planted her face.
Yeah.
Good job, Aubrey. We'll be back.
Paragon Sports welcomes State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino and his family to Elk City. And he's proud to support this area's schools, students, and their activities. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. With surprisingly great rates for auto coverage and surprisingly great rates for everyone.
For your surprisingly great rates, contact your local State Farm agent today.
If you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino in Elk City today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Welcome back. Pioneer Festival, Pioneer School District, east of Wacomas, up here by Enid. A little jaunt this afternoon. Newkirk Tigers, Elk City Elkettes. Got out of the first inning, three up, three down.
Yeah, I think it's just about 8 miles from the speed trap over there in Wacomas. So.
Newkirk is?
Yeah, no. I don't know where Newkirk, but where we're at.
Oh, yeah. No, Newkirk's north of here.
Yeah, it's like going towards
up by the Kansas line.
Yeah.
Lead off as usual, Ella Satilli.
Friend of mine's up in Shidler, and they played Newkirk. Shidler's a little bitty town.
Called strike.
Up by Kansas.
Sewell is the pitcher. Birdie fouls that one. Ooh. Just out of reach, first baseman. Not very happy with herself. She really wanted that one.
Well, first pitch was outside, and this one came inside. Yeah, that's what we're going to see, inside, outside.
Yeah. Well, if we had the pitcher's box, then she's stepping way out there, wouldn't she?
I didn't look. I was looking at the plate because it's kind of dirty.
Low.
Good two job and by two. Birdie. Get back in the count.
Right. Outside and low, last two pitches. See if they throw something to hit right here. She fouls it back. Good job. She's got a little different ball spin.
Yeah.
Than what we've seen in a while.
She's not just bringing it in there, but she's moving the ball. And
right. There's a good little, charging right fielder makes the play.
Good play by the right fielder.
Yeah. I thought that might drop. Riley doing a little better job crowding the plate here. One out. And there for a strike.
Well, that may back her off the plate a little bit. Yep. That was on the inside part of the plate.
And it does.
Yeah.
A little bit.
But they're going to come outside. So
yeah.
You just
need to set up middle of.
Staying inside.
High. Ball going. Little chopper. Going to be trouble.
Job by Riles.
Right.
It's a tough play for the second baseman.
Yeah. Bobbled it a little bit and then threw it in the dirt, and first baseman bobbled it, but I think Riley would have been safe anyway. Abby Joe. See if we can get one she likes. They're definitely staying inside, outside, not throwing anything down the middle.
Sure like those Nikes of Abby Joe's. Are those like KD's or something? Kyrie's?
Yeah, I'm not the shoot. That and sky high, but going to be playable by left field. Just a little under that.
Yeah, Riley, good job working off.
Right.
Getting back after the caught was made.
Aubrey Pogue is up. Low. Ball one to Aubrey. Two outs. Line drive out by Ella and a pop, big pop, high fly to left field by Abby Joe. Oh, a little dinker from Aubrey to first base, and just like that, we're out. We'll be back.
We absolutely love fulfilling the goal of the client. A home really is your biggest security, right? It's your safe place. It's where your family feels protected. It's your own space, and we love working with our clients and finding them that security space. Basically, we want to get people where they want to be, both physically and financially. I'm Amy Robbins, and my company is Moxie Realty. MoxieRealty.com.
Welcome back, J.Y. Dillon Satilli. Pioneer Softball Classic, we're calling it. I don't know what it's called, but it sounds good.
I like it.
Newkirk Tigers. Dillon looked them up on Game Changer. That's a pretty solid season. What'd you say they were?
20-8.
20-8.
Yeah, played some good teams. Beat good competition, yeah.
We're in the top of the second. 0-0. Good hard hit ball. They're hustling in. Oh, no. Communication out there in center field. Both of them got to it, and somebody didn't back off. Got to have those, Dylan. Got to have those.
It was right in the middle of both of them, but yeah. They were both right there.
Oh, good throw by Riley. Got on the bunt. Elo bobbled a little bit, fired it to Riley, and Riley throws it back to third. Yeah. Back caught the girl sleeping.
Elo did real good. Yeah. Staying with that ball. Yeah. She got that arm. She's going to get her out. And you're right. I mean, we
almost got a double play on that deal. Good pitch by Aubrey right there. Swinging for a strike. Oh. There's a little flare into right. Going to score the run.
These girls can swing it, man.
Yeah.
They're good.
Newkirk strikes first.
They did a good job with situational hitting and bunting, get that run in.
Right.
You know, hitting the ball to the right side, getting that bunt down, and hitting the ball to the right side, scoring the run. And that was a good pitch. I think you need to give her another compliment, Jay.
I think I need to flirt with the umpire a little more.
Yeah. Foul ball.
Foul ball. Whew. Crashing hard and actually over Elo's head right there.
She had, I thought she had a chance to get it. I thought she was about to grab it. But.
Been nice to get that out right there. 1-1 to the batter, Sewell. Good pitch up.
Yeah, good rise ball
right there. Working well. One ball and two strikes to Sewell here.
He's the pitcher, right?
I believe so. Right there inside, called strike. Right on the river.
I need to wipe the plate off. I can't even see it. Can you?
Not much. Two outs. Runner swinging. Pitch on Aubrey right now. She dialed in pretty nice.
Yeah, she's looking good.
Nothing's been in the dirt. Nothing's wild. It's just dancing either side of the plate right now. Good pitch low. 1-1 to the batter. She's crowding the line, isn't she?
A little toss back to first base. Keep her in check.
Just let her know we can.
Yep.
St. Andrews is the batter. Riley's actually played ball with this girl.
She was a pure girl?
No, a Pulse.
Pulse?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Her dad coaches a Pulse.
How long was she with Pulse? It wasn't very long, was it?
No.
Well, no. I mean, y'all found her a good home with Morris. And
there you go. Good strikeout right there. We'll be back. Word from the Dyson boys.
Barber Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Quentin Nichols is from Elk City, a graduate of Elk City. You got Chris Coy. He is Elk City born and bred. Ray Haven is from Cheyenne, so he is a Western Oklahoma guy, of course. Kirby McBroom, Elk City guy. Of course, my dad, David Dyson, Elk City. Ed Stewart, who is our sales manager, is from Clinton.
Barber Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Welcome back. Bottom of two. Newkirk was able to manage to get one across. Good hit. or I guess it was error by our part, letting that fall and then button her around. And then got the little line drive over to right field to score after she got to third.
That was a perfect hit to the right side.
Yes.
And those are the little situational things that good teams do.
Right. Knowing where to go the ball, not trying to do too much with it right there, just make sure you score a run. I mean.
Yeah. And on that ball hit to right field, Jill did a good job getting that ball in into second base, knowing that we're not going to get that girl at home.
Well, that was what you were talking about earlier, knowing when you can't make a play at home, don't throw it home.
So that could have saved us another run, just keeping that girl at first base. Right.
First pitch in there, called strike to BB. BB hit a mountain of a home run in the first game and hit another one foul that went even further. Outside.
Newkirk was probably watching that. I think they might have been around for that one. So I don't know if they're going to come at BB too hard.
Notice Murray having a little chat with our outfielders after that. Error. Good off-speed pitch right there. Got BB out front. Sometimes after BB hits that one or two,
she gets kind of slumped.
Yeah, she gets – there's a good line drive foul.
She saw that one. That one's going to go out of play past the fence.
One ball and two strikes to BB. No outs. Jada Kimball on deck. Good changeup. Got her swinging. Something we talked about, strikeouts, Dylan. Mm-hmm. We got too many against good teams and too many against the lesser teams. We
struck out 21 times in the last two games. Yeah. That's not good. That's never good.
Strike.
Hitting's an attitude. You got to have confidence. You just got to go up there and do it. You don't have to be the best athlete just to go hit. It's a
timing.
Timing.
1-1 to Jada. Swinging. Strike two. Good same battle. Pitch. Jada hustling.
He's there.
Going to be safe. Little bobble by the shortstop. Made it happen.
Yep, that ball was supposed to be off the plate a little bit more. I think she left it close to the plate.
I felt like it was the same pitch she tried. Just got her twice swinging on strike and tried to come back on it. Jada made an adjustment, hit the ball hard at shortstop. Shortstop bobbled it a little bit, and Jada's speed got her there. Jeremy Moeller. In there for a strike.
They're coming inside quite a bit.
Called strike.
Jade is working on the bag over there. She got a good jump. Oh, Lord.
Oh, we waited too long.
Oh. Shortstop's fast.
Yep. A little base running error there. I understand what we were trying to do, but we were too late. As soon as that ball going to first.
Yeah, this team's they're not going to fall for that.
Two outs. Another one of those base running errors that we plagued by the last couple of games. Outside. First ball on Jera.
Well, we need to get something going with two right here. Foul tip.
Foul tip caught, swinging. We'll be back.
Once in a while, you find a company that operates on excellence. They hire people who are serious about safety and quality. It continues with the equipment they use, dependable, sturdy, safe. Then there's the way the companies run, with clear expectations, high standards, and fairness for employees, and commitment to delivering the very best for customers. Anadarko Dozer and Trucking is one of those companies. Anadarko Dozer is dedicated to excellence. To become one of the crew, visit AnadarkoDozer.com.
Welcome back. J.Y. Dillon Stilley, top of the third. This game's moving a little quicker, not near the base runners we've had.
Well, I mean, this is a good challenge for us. We need it.
Right.
After playing Mahal, Orlando, this would be a good challenge for us. I'd like to see how we respond.
Got her swinging at a high one for the first strike. That one was running down the pipe. We got it fouled back, though. Good hustle by BB there. BB's going to make just about every play she can.
Yeah, or she's going to – she's definitely going to try.
Oh, nice strikeout by Aubrey on three pitches. You know, their pitcher's doing a really good job keeping us kind of off balance. I mean, she's not overly powering us, but it's got a lot of movement, and it's diving and cutting outside, cutting inside.
Yeah, inside, outside. A little bit of change of speed.
Yeah.
And you're right, like there's some old dive. So, yeah.
Ball one to the batter. Vape.
Vap.
Vap. Not vape.
Maybe VAP is short for like Vaporuso or something.
Two balls on the batter. VAP. Oh,
good change up.
Good change up by Aubrey. Totally fooled on that. VAP's 0 for 1 today.
Good pitch.
Good pitch inside there.
Good hard rise ball inside or hard curve ball inside. Notice, I mean, we got a left-handed hitter up, but notice we still have Jill playing the wind.
Yep.
Playing the gap.
Nice. Outside. That outside. Should be ball four. No?
Full count.
Full count? I missed a strike. Is that one inside was called a strike?
I think there was two early on. Rise ball up.
Aubrey going to make a play on that little pop up there for the second out.
She's a woman on a mission today, or at least this game she is. She's doing it all.
That's her third defensive play, isn't it?
Yeah.
Low inside, ball one. Carlton, she's 0 for 1 today.
She lead off?
No. I think she's third. There's a hard hit in the gap going to the fence. Going to be in for a double.
Nice hit. Wow.
That was a good rip.
She's a two-hole.
Back house.
They're four-hole early. Free. I think she almost hit one out, didn't she? She hit one deep somewhere. No, or is that the one they got mixed up
that
on?
That was Bradley. Bradley that hit it deep. There's another deep hit ball. Oh, man. Another double. Scores another run for Newkirk. Got to play that off the wall.
Well, she got to the fence. She probably, if she would have turned, she probably could have caught it.
Jill calling them off. Good job by Jill coming in.
That was tough with two outs.
Right. That could have been trouble.
Yeah.
Good job by Jill right there. That we're down, find ourselves down to the bottom of third. Be back.
Tips Insurance Agency is an independent insurance agency. Justin Twyman, what does that mean?
Well, Sean, that means that we can go out and shop multiple carriers. We're not tied to one line of business. That way, if one line of business declines you, we have another line of business to come in and quote. Tips Agency, we currently represent a little over 100 carriers. So we have an outlet for your insurance needs.
What's the best way to contact you at the Tips Agency?
You can stop by my office, 314 North Main Street, just north of Walgreens. Or you can call my cell phone. Cell phone number is 580-374-1052.
Jay White, Dylan Satilli back. Pioneer Softball Classic. 7 or 8, 9 batters. Jill's back in the lineup, looks like. Today, after first game. Elo's the 8-hole up at bat. Elk City finds themselves down 2-0. Bottom of three here. Good job by Sewell today so far, keeping the girls off balance.
Yep.
In, out, up, down, drop balls.
Hitters are doing a good job for Newkirk.
That a curveball, Dylan?
I couldn't tell.
Yeah, we're kind of in a not a great spot to see how they're ending. Looked like started over the plate and dove out. There's Elo getting one in the gap.
Good battle by Elo. Not getting rattled.
Jill met her for her first at bat today. See if Jill can get something going. I like Jill against this matchup a little better than some others. In there for a strike. Coming right at her. Sure like to see her get some confidence.
And, yeah, just get her hit right here and get some confidence or a walk or just anything to just kind of build her up. There we go.
Oh, nice bunt. Bobbled.
Now we got birdie.
Yeah.
Up.
Now here we are.
Great spot.
Eight nine get on. Great bunt. Bobbled. Probably going to be an error, but it's still.
Oh yeah. 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 It was a fielding error, but either way, put pressure on the defense.
Right.
Executed the bunt. That's what you got to do, man.
Oh, birdie popped straight up. Dead gummit. Well, it's just unfortunate deal. Birdie pops it straight up. Catcher drops it, but it was in play, infield, so it wasn't a foul. So runner had to go. Elo kind of hung out into dry. Not much you can do there, is there, Dylan?
I mean, maybe work off a little bit more. There's no reason to tag on that.
Right. Tough call on Riley right there, low and outside. That going to get through. Yeah, a bobble. He's sending Jill home.
Oh, we got birdie.
Birdie out hung to dry. Oh.
That's done it. Great defense.
Right. Good job by Newkirk there.
Yeah. She charged birdie and made her go one way, and as soon as she did, she threw that ball and got her out.
Yep.
Great play. I think they work on their rundowns and pickles quite a bit. because that's a second pickle that we've been in, and they got us out. One throw, we're out.
Nine outside, the ball for ball two to Abby Joe. Two outs. Riley thought that was three outs, started walking off then. Outside, ball three. Green light again or no?
Why not?
A little trouble. Blooper trouble.
Shortstop.
Shortstop makes a great play.
She's a player, dude.
Well, dead gummit, Dylan.
We got one back.
Be back. Welcome back, J.Y. Dylan Satilli, Pioneer Classic. Sheber, Bradley, and Sewell up for Newkirk Tigers.
5, 6, and 7 hole.
That's not like Birdie to get in a situation like that usually.
Well, she thought the catcher was going to make a throw somewhere else.
Right. And the catcher played it perfect.
She did. She baited her into it, I think. She was watching the whole time. That's a good catcher.
Good pitch by Aubrey. Swinging. Strike.
Texted a friend of mine from Scheidler. He says they play Newkirk all the time, you know, over the years. And usually Newkirk, I mean, they always just – whip them, just beat them bad. But
really?
This year they played them 3-2. They lost 3-2 off of a walk-off line drive or something, and lost. But so this is one of Scheidler's biggest nemesis.
Is it Newkirk?
Newkirk, yeah. They just one of those tough games.
One ball and two strikes to Sheber. Little change up, popped up to Birdie for the first out. Good pitch there. Change up.
Yep.
Batter had two strikes on her, had to do something with it.
Just poked it to Birdie. We have here the catcher?
Nope.
No.
St. Andrews is the catcher.
Okay.
High fastball for a ball there. Got her swinging that time. Bradley is 1-for-1 today with an RBI. Had one in RBI in the first inning. Oh, good pitch, Bobby. Fooled her on that.
It would have been in the second inning.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't score anything in the first. Yeah. I apologize.
Yeah, it's the four way came up, hit a ball deep, and I think she's the one that hit.
The little one, to a little flare to right field.
Yeah. Yeah.
Two outs, got her swinging that time.
Yeah, Free had a double, and then they bunted, moved her over. And
one of those things, they're doing a better job hitting when they got runners in scoring position. Mm-hmm. Sometimes that's been one of our problems.
Yeah.
Fouled back.
These hitters, they're not trying to do too much. They're just
taking the ball, taking what's given to them.
Yeah.
One and one to the pitcher, Sewell, for Newkirk.
She's got some little bit of swag in the box.
Fouled off. One ball and two strikes. Fouled another one back. Count remains 1-2. Two outs. Newkirk leading Elk City 2-1. Top of the fourth here. One thing I'd say, you know, as hot as it was earlier, Dylan, it was it's starting to cool off pretty nice. Little dribbler.
Got her.
Got her. Good job by Riley.
Yeah, so, the sun's going down a little bit. Yeah. I kind of like it.
Yeah, it's doesn't stay 100 all the way till 10 o'clock.
No.
We'll be back.
If your garage door looks like this, there's only one person to call. Red Dirt Garage Doors. They'll literally get you back on track and rolling up and down again. Red Dirt Garage Door does residential and commercial sales and service, serving Southwest Oklahoma and the Texas Panhandle. You can call for a free estimate at 580-482-6369. That's 580-482-6369. Red Dirt Garage Doors, keeping you on track and the garage door looking good.
Welcome back, Jay White, Dylan Satilli. Murray having a little chat with the umpires. Wonder what that's over.
Well, he's being cool. He's being calm a little bit.
I haven't seen anything that...
Well, Murray's a smart, smart guy. He sees... Oh, I'm wondering if he's... I mean, was there some sort of... Supposed to be some sort of... infield fly or something, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
When Birdie got thrown out at third, or no, not Birdie.
When she was on second.
Man, I don't know.
The pitch on Aubrey right there, swinging strike one. Boy, her ball tails off a bunch, doesn't it?
Yeah, she's got good breaking movement on her pitch.
Outside. Now by Aubrey.
Same pitch, but change of speeds on it. Came in with the same spin, but just died for a ball.
Outside again. 2-0, 2-1. No outs. See if we can get something happening here in.
Anything will work.
Bottom of the fourth. Aubrey fouls that one back.
Good cut by the cleanup, Pogue.
Trying to find out what happened to all of the balls.
Well, I don't know.
Yeah. Down to playing with one ball. There's a rip by Aubrey. Bobbled by center fielder.
Yeah,
hard hit.
Yeah, it was a hard hit. She had, I mean, the center fielder had it. She was there.
But
she,
it was dying. It's going to be a tough play. But
oh, yeah. Yeah, good job by Pogue.
Brianna Butler up. No outs. Called strike outside. She's really starting everybody off quite a bit outside. Little dribbler, going to be close to a double play. Good job by Aubrey sliding into that.
Man, I don't want her to get hurt.
One out. That was a hit right back to the pitcher. She goes back to the second baseman trying to turn double play.
Yep. Wisely getting that lead runner. Yeah.
Little blooper by Jada. BB was back. Good dive back by BB. I thought that was getting through. Second base.
I mean, the first baseman was – if she was covering the bag and had her foot on the bag, she might could have got the out.
Right.
But she played it like it was a tag play, not expecting the throw back to first.
Jared Moeller's up, 0 for 1. It's a game. Two outs, 0-1 to Jarrah. Fouls that one off. I think Jarrah just needs a little more experience seeing some movement pitches.
For sure, yeah.
You know, she does well with the 55-mile-an-hour fastballs that, you know, she can get on. But those ones that are dancing around, moving all over the place, she's struggling with a little bit here the last Weatherford game, this game, game before this. One ball, two strikes. Up high around the chin there.
She number 10, she brought it that time.
That's about the fastest pitch I've seen.
Yeah. It's almost like throwing your fastball for your changeup.
Got her swinging. We'll be back.
Paragon Sports welcomes State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino and his family to Elk City. And he's proud to support this area's schools, students, and their activities. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. With surprisingly great rates for auto coverage and surprisingly great rates for everyone.
For your surprisingly great rates, contact your local State Farm agent today.
If you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino in Elk City today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Welcome back. Pioneer Classic. Northern Oklahoma.
It's a really good ball game.
Yeah. 2-1. Newkirk Tigers lead the Elk City Elkettes. We are in the top of the fifth.
Newkirk's played a really clean, clean game. This our catcher?
This is St. Andrews, I believe. Okay. In there for a strike.
Good job, Ivory, getting ahead.
I believe she had a strikeout first, her first at bat, if I remember correctly.
Yep.
High for ball two.
Our game changer lady must be sleeping. Oh, there she is.
That and fouled back. Be 2-2 the count. Another foul ball.
Good job by St. Andrews battling with that one, fouling that one off. Just got her. Wow.
Riley was going for the pop-up and couldn't quite get there and had to let it drop and regather. It was kind of blocked. Isn't that what you saw, Dylan?
That's what I think happened. Yeah. We may just have to watch the screen.
Mm-hmm. The pitch in there for a strike. Free is the batter. I believe this is their nine hole. Is that correct, Dylan?
Yeah.
Outside, ball one.
There's two frees. They play in the ones play shortstop, ones play second base.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Frozer on that. One ball, two strikes, one out. Little chopper foul. What class is Newkirk, Dylan?
Well, I couldn't find them
in a
ranked as under A or B.
Oh, nice pitch by Aubrey right there. Called a ball. Two and two.
I'm going to ask my friend Britton Wehunt.
Full count.
Need this out before we get back to the top of the lineup.
Foul that back. Newkirk leads the game 2-1 right now. We're in the top of the fifth. Full count to Free.
Stay with it, BB. Nice job.
Job by BB getting over, making the little dribbler, and getting back to first base for the second out before we get here to the top of the lineup. This is Vap, the leadoff.
Jammed her up on that one.
Fouled out of play. On one, two outs. Vap's 0 for 2 today. Hits that ball. Come on. We got to do better. Not sure why Jada gave up on that, if she lost it or thought Birdie was drifting back or.
Well, Birdie stopped like she got called off, yeah. So.
That's what I thought. Those are plays that Jada had made earlier this year and mostly ends up being a double. Swinging for a strike. Carlton. Little change up, fouled off.
All right, Poke. Uh-oh. Oh, good thing it's a foul ball.
Yeah.
All right, Poke, we're up.
One and one to Carlton.
All right. Good job by Bird. I heard her talking that time.
Yep. Final out there. Be back in a minute.
We absolutely love fulfilling the goal of the client. A home really is your biggest security, right? It's your safe place. It's where your family feels protected. It's your own space. And we love working with our clients and finding them that security space. Basically, we want to get people where they want to be, both physically and financially. I'm Amy Robbins, and my company is Moxie Realty. MoxieRealty.com.
Welcome back. J.Y. Dillon Satilli. It is the bottom of the fifth inning. Elk City finds themselves down 2-1 to Newkirk. 3A school from Northern Oklahoma.
Denny, you want to say hi to everybody?
Hi, everyone on Big Elk TV.
Tell your name.
This is Dennis Tilley, and I hope you're having a great night.
Danny D. Up watching baby sis play. Home from college. Emily Lawrence, the batter. Outside ball one. Swinging through that.
She had a good hit. What is it, last at bat?
I believe so. She's one for one today.
Shortstop. Oh, good eye.
Tough one to lay off right there.
I don't even know if Elo was ready for that one to come in.
Yeah. Been throwing everything outside and got one inside there. Pitcher Sewell mixing it up nice.
Ball, foul ball. Thankfully.
One ball, two strikes to Emily. Jill Metter on deck.
Give Nilo a little pump up, pep talk. You got this.
Last inning we were able to get, or third inning we were able to get 8-9 on, no outs. There's a little play, blooper, same thing last time.
Like it.
I'll take it all day long. Not trying to do too much with it. Making the ball come to you.
If we try to bunt again with Jill.
No outs. Good swing out there by Jill. Fouls it off.
Like it.
Being aggressive. Oh, close. Thought it pulled her off, but great job by Jill moving her around. One run game, that's critical right there.
Birdie had a hit and reached on an error as well. She had her first. Well. Yeah. No. She fight out to right field the first at bat, maybe. Good eye.
One ball to Elissa Tilley. See if she can get something deep right here and tie it up. There it is. No. Oh, my goodness. Second baseman makes a great play, and the ball crawled up her arm and down her back. Ends up dropping on the ground.
That's a good hard hit.
Yep. I thought there's no way she's getting there to that. That second baseman's pretty quick.
Well, her big sister's a shortstop, and her shortstop is a stud. Got called an error.
Riley fouls the first pitch back. These are always pitchers that I think gives Riley a hard time, that ball diving on her.
Yeah.
See if she can make something happen right here, poke something in a gap. Good eye. Ooh. We better not be dollying around.
Dilly-dollying.
Mm-hmm. 1-1 to Riley, one out. High. 2-1 to Riley. See if we can make something happen right here. 2-0 hitter, one out. Got super seniors up.
Riles didn't like that one. Thought it was a little low. Maybe your hair outside, too.
She's called that pitch quite a bit
she's
today.
She's been consistent with it, but, you know, you've trained. Al.
Oh, man, what a catch.
Safe.
Oh, man, that center fielder made a heck of a play, didn't she?
That was an amazing play, though.
Riley just ripped that ball deep.
That's one of Riley's hardest hits all year. She got robbed, man.
Two outs. Man, that was I thought that was going to do it right there. That would.
With time constraints, we need to get a run across quick.
Right. What time did we start?
I'm not sure.
It was
–
We were
– I'm telling you, Jay, she's cursed, man. She's been hit by the – she – I think she wants to get hit sometimes, but –
Looks for it. Well, our best average hitter's up. Pogue. I like the spot we're in right here.
I do too.
We got to be getting close on time.
Yes.
What did we start that? Supposed to start at 6, were we? We started not far, 6:15. I mean, we're hour and 20 minutes in.
We need to set our timer next time, Jay.
Well, I forget we're playing timed game.
I know.
If we were a good coach, we'd do that, Dylan.
It's true. That's why we're on the radio.
Maybe it's finish the inning. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah.
So.
I know that game before ours, our first game, went 6 innings, and it, you know, was a high-scoring game. And so maybe we got a little more time than what we think.
Right. Two and two to Aubrey. Nobody better right here. Right there it is. It's going to be in the gap. Yeah, baby.
Score three.
Score three.
Stay there, Pogue. Nice job.
Yeah.
How about that freshman, Jay Wyatt?
Holy smokes. That's it, baby.
Those are the kind of hits I've been expecting this whole game.
Right.
From a lot of our hitters.
Well, Riley's was very similar, just a little closer. The center fielder made it with an outstretched leaping catch. This one was just a little further toward left field, and, man, it was perfect.
He's got her slow pitch stance going, staying straight up. It's trouble. Oh, good
scoop by first. Good job by the girls. I guess we're going to the top of the sixth. We'll be back.
Barber Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Quint Nichols is from Elk City, a graduate of Elk City. You got Chris Coy. He is Elk City born and bred. Ray Haven is from Cheyenne, so he is a Western Oklahoma guy, of course. Kirby McBroom, Elk City guy. Of course, my dad, David Dyson, Elk City. Ed Stewart, who is our sales manager, is from Clinton.
Barber Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Welcome back. Jay White, Dylan Satilli here in Pioneer School District. Big inning by the Elks right there. Aubrey Poe, what a big play right there.
Yeah, that pitch right in her wheelhouse, man.
She ripped it.
Took advantage of it.
Hard hit ball.
Yeah, that's the one she was looking for, I imagine.
Got a hit. She's heading the count 2-0 and expecting a strike right there. And took it.
But we got some big hitters coming up for Newkirk, though.
Yep.
So we're not in the clear.
Right.
For sure.
3, 4, 5 hole.
Yeah. These are definitely their three best hitters, from what I can recall.
Well, so far today, we kept them 1 for 6, so. Oh, called strike. One and one. The back house. The batter. Oh.
Got her.
Wow. How about Poe, man?
Knocked her glove off. Knocked her mask off.
Yikes.
Took her rip right at her. Kind of dribbled down between her legs. Fell behind her. She couldn't hardly find it. Everything come flying off. She's able to gather stuff.
She picked that ball up, and she made sure she got her feet right, got her out. Wow. That's tough. That's our Moxie State Farm Barbara Dyson playing the game right there. Garbarino and Tips all in one right there. Shoot.
Hope she's gathered herself here after that.
I think she's pumped up, man. It's a shortstop.
Yeah. Little extra gas on that one. And there for strike. Shortstop free. Maybe the older sister. A little low. One and one. Raking a little dirt back in front of the pitcher's rubber. Oh. Bringing a little heat.
Yeah. Number 4 free took a big old swing of that. Her head was looking at Coach Murray. Oh, got some adjustments. There we go. Go foul.
Ooh. Okay. Just barely.
Looked like it's gonna go a little bit more fouler than what it did. But kinda hung up right there.
Right. We kinda shaded over towards center field a little bit with Jada, and long ways to go for that.
Yeah.
Change up. Job, Abby, keeping that in front.
I think we changed speeds right here. Down in the zone. Oh, rise ball up and away.
For the second out. Top of the sixth. When we started this, they told us we had 20 minutes left in the game, so.
Be good. Get out of the inning through the middle.
Sheber, the batter. High for ball one. Jammed her there with inside fastball. Foul. Down the first, outside of the first baseline. One ball, one strike. Sheber on Sheber. Got away from Aubrey a little bit there. Two balls and a strike.
Be good going into the sixth inning, running out of time, you know, getting through the middle of their lineup.
Good inside pitch there by Aubrey. Got her. Swinging. Full count. Way to come right. We're doing a better job of coming at the hitters right this game.
Yeah.
Than I've seen us do in a whole lot of games. No. A little high there. End up with a walk. Nobody hurt. Bradley, the batter. Bradley's 1-for-2 today. I think she's the one that we talked about in that hit that little flare to right. She's going the opposite direction with them.
Yeah, I wonder if we try to jam her up. You may just need to just stay away. Don't want her to pull something and...
Oh, gets away. Your runner going to advance. 1-1.
Yeah, you don't want to give her something that she can hit over the fence.
No. Got her swinging right there down the little inside pitch.
Way ahead.
Fouled off.
Tried to get her with a rise ball right there.
Bradley's a batter, 1-for-2 today. 1-2 on her right now, though. Aubrey goes up a little high.
Another change up. Or another rise ball, I mean. The ball had some heat on it.
Abby just throws it down to second just to let her know that we can. Full count. Same position we were with the last batter. Oh. Close pitch. Called a ball.
Now we got the pitcher back up.
Sewell. Sewell's 0-for-2 today. Oh, gets away. Runners advance, scoring position.
We just need Pogue to take her a deep breath.
Mm-hmm.
Just go with her mechanics. Well, I imagine Sewell, she's excited for this chance to help herself out.
Fouled back.
Try and get the lead back or tie it up.
Base hit somewhere probably ties it up.
Yeah. Yeah, two outs. They're running.
Pitch by Aubrey right there. Getting ahead, 1-2.
I heard him calling her Anna Lee.
Yeah. Got her. Swinging. Big pitch by Pogue. That's big time. We'll be back.
Once in a while, you find a company that operates on excellence. They hire people who are serious about safety and quality. It continues with the equipment they use. Dependable, sturdy, safe. Then there's the way the companies run. With clear expectations, high standards, and fairness for employees. And commitment to delivering the very best for customers. Anadarko Dozer and Trucking is one of those companies. Anadarko Dozer is dedicated to excellence. To become one of the crew, visit AnadarkoDozer.com.
Well, if we can get a run or two, we should be able to close this out. been about 15 minutes since they told me 20 minutes.
Yeah, I got about 8 minutes on the timer, 9 minutes, but I waited a minute or two, put 20 on my phone.
Low in there to Jada, ball one.
That's a good eye. We just got to look for our pitch right here. Just look for it. Don't chase. And that's what
she
did.
Little flare. He falls in there by Jada.
Big hit. Big hit. Pitcher tried to quick pitch her a little bit.
Yep.
Jada just got in the box, and then she started throwing it. Backfired. I think Jada got in a pickle. Was it this game? We tried to back steal her.
Yeah, no, that was last game.
That was last game.
Fouled off by Jara there. 1-1 to Jara. Jara doing a good job taking her time. Not getting in a rush, getting in the box. This pitcher's wound up ready to go. Called outside strike.
Fair ball.
Called fair ball off the third baseman.
Yeah. She was falling foul, but the ball hit her
in the body and popped back in play. And we got runners first and second, no outs. Emily Lawrence, 8-9.
Elo's 2-for-2.
That going to fall in? Nope, foul.
I like the confidence right here by Elo.
Owen 1.
Element of surprise.
Good job. Elo getting a bun down right there. Caught him off guard. They were able to make a play, though. It got a little deep, but.
I mean, it was almost in kind of a little trouble spot where it was.
In between first and pitcher.
Who's got it? Oh, Lordy.
Oh.
Muller wisely goes to third and gets on the base.
Right. Another base running error by Elk City. We got to wait till they throw the ball. We got to know that. Surprised they sent Jill on that. With birdie up. One and one to birdie here. Two outs.
They got her 0-for-3 today.
Oh, another great grab by the right fielder on a hard hit ball. And they're playing. They're pretty
good
soft.
Good defense, man. Yeah.
Yeah.
That was a great hit by Bird.
Man, we have to know on that play that's hit to third baseman when we got a runner on third.
You don't have to score.
You don't have to score. You don't have to run. Know the situation, and we just take off blindly. We got to do better. We cannot. We'll not win any playoff games playing that way. Back in a minute.
Tips Insurance Agency is an independent insurance agency. Justin Twyman, what does that mean?
Well, Sean, that means that we can go out and shop multiple carriers. We're not tied to one line of business. That way, if one line of business declines you, we have another line of business to come in and quote. Tips Agency, we currently represent a little over 100 carriers. So we have an outlet for your insurance needs.
What's the best way to contact you at the Tips Agency?
You can stop by my office, 314 North Main Street, just north of Walgreens. Or you can call my cell phone. Cell phone number is 580-374-1052.
Welcome back, Jay White, Dylan Satilli. I guess we are going to play the seventh inning.
Well, we're the
home team.
Still got about 4 minutes left.
According to my clock. Well, according to mine, we're done. But mine doesn't count. So we get out of this, we're done. Either way, 1-1. To St. Andrews, the catcher for Newkirk.
St. Andrews, the 8-hole. Got to get her out. Got to get these first two girls out. Because then they got the top of their lineup.
Yeah. That was a hard hit ball off the wall.
Man, she crushed that.
Yep.
Pogue left it hanging over the middle of the plate.
Mm-hmm. She got every bit of that one. Going to have a courtesy runner.
For the catcher.
Free, the second baseman. 9-hole hitters up. Newkirk not going away quietly. Didn't expect them to, did we?
No.
I know the wind is blowing right to left here looking at us, but Dylan, why are we shading so much towards center field? I know you got wind issues, but 9-hole hitter. Going to have trouble catching up to Aubrey. If she's going to hit anything, it's probably going right. Don't you think?
Well, possibly. I mean, I understand playing the wind. You know, I'm guessing that's just what Murray feels comfortable with.
Right. Well, the wind's died significantly. The foul pole has still not been over at a 90-degrees angle. Pop up, foul, Abby Joe right underneath it for the first out.
Good pitch, good job by Abby Joe catching that.
Lead off Vap for Newkirk.
Now this might be one where I would maybe shade.
Left-handed hitter here.
Yeah. Good pitch.
And therefore strike. Fouled back. Head over here, 0-2. One out. Runner on second. After a smoke ball by St. Andrews to the fence. Lucky it didn't go over.
Good pitch.
Oh, nice pitch by Aubrey. Called a ball.
Yep. JoJo, when she set up, you know, over on the chalk and then went right to her. It was a great spot. Good pitch.
Rise ball there. Up and out of the strike zone.
Good chase pitches when you're ahead.
Right. Good job by BB playing that. Right down the first baseline. Pulled that change up.
Nice pitch.
0-2, or two outs, I'm sorry.
BB did a good job staying down on that pitch.
Yes.
Or on that ball hit to her, anyway.
Carlton's a batter.
Mmm. Carlton's 1-for-3. Way to see spray charts. Maybe. Good pitch. Good pitch.
Got her swinging. 1-1. Two outs. Top of the seventh here. Newkirk down to their last out. Fouled back by Carlton. One ball, two strikes.
Polk struck her out earlier. Nice to shut down Newkirk with another strikeout. Ouch. Ouch. Walk that out, Abby. Walk that out, Abby. Walk it out.
Foul tipped off the catcher and then the umpire. Mask and mask. Big cut by Carlton.
Still way ahead. Don't have to come at her. Just keep her guessing.
Right. One ball, two strikes. It's Carlton. Got her swinging. Just like that. Ball game. Good job, Elkettes. We'll be back with some stats after these messages. Nice win there by Elkettes over a really nice club.
Good quality win for the Elkettes.
That's one of the better defenses I've seen.
Yeah.
Newkirk Tigers, well coached, very well coached. Caught us in some situations. I don't know that is necessarily right. They have four errors. I don't remember four errors on them. Do you remember, Dylan? Did you remember them having that many? 4-2 win, Elkettes. They 27 at-bats, 4 runs, 7 hits. Big key this game, 3 strikeouts.
Yep.
The fewest amount of strikeouts. Pogue pitched 110 pitches that game, so she's probably well over 200 pitches today.
Yeah.
So I didn't look at the first deal, but a good non-conference, non-district win against a good team. Still got some things to work out that I would like to see us do different.
Communication
and base running is,
we got some bunts down today, which is good.
Right. Our talent wins us a lot of games. Our mistakes are going to get us beat when we're
get those teams
that equal us in talent. And so until we can start playing some mistake-free ball, I don't see us making a lot of noise until we can start playing mistake-free or limit the mistakes.
We've struggled with it here lately. Early on in the season, we hardly had any mistakes.
That's right. Any errors, we were fielding like crazy. And a couple of drop balls in the outfield today, miscommunication errors, two or three base running situations again where we got tagged out, not being in the right place, not doing the right things.
Yeah.
Going forward, playoffs are right around the corner, regionals, and we're going to have to shore some of that stuff up. But we sure appreciate you guys tuning in here at Pioneer Softball Festival. We'll be back Tuesday at home with Anadarko, and Thursday is senior night.
versus Clinton.
Versus Clinton. Hope everybody can join us this week. Oh, man, we had a great crowd against Weatherford. Like to see everybody continue to come out and enjoy it and watch this team. They're really doing well.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I'm talking about the bad stuff, but we still won a ball game.
Big and, hits.
Big hits.
Big hits by Pogue.
I mean, Pogue comes up and the all everything freshman, you know.
She made a lot of plays and great
made them, with their bat. So, once again, we'll be signing off, but thanks everybody for listening in. We'll see you at the ball fields Tuesday night.
Thank you for tuning in to this presentation of Elk City Athletics, presented by the Bank of Western Oklahoma, where people come first. Big Elk TV and Cool 94 are a part of the Paragon Communications Network, and any distribution or rebroadcast without permission is strictly prohibited. Paragon Communications is owned and operated by Blake Brewer. General Manager is Gabe Edney. Sports Director, Sean Wilson. Once again, thank you for tuning in. Until next time, go Big Elks.